Hello, all you beautiful people. This week, we're going to be doing something a little bit different on the show. The past few weeks, you may have heard me talking about the video series that I'm sharing around laying the foundation for your entrepreneurial success. That video series is actually dropping this week, so we decided to simultaneously share the audio here on the podcast. So this episode is the audio from part one of that series, Setting Your Vision. I'll also be sharing the audio from the subsequent videos over the course of the next week, but to actually watch the video and catch some of the visuals we share, you can go over to millennialmm.com/vision to check that out. We also have a comment section on that page that I encourage you to dive into and share your thoughts. I'll be interacting on there as well. And with that, enjoy part one of the series. Hey guys, welcome to the Millennial Mastermind. Psyched to have you here today. The purpose of this video is to teach you something that I have found very beneficial in my life, and I think it'll help you too with creating a more intentional and fulfilling life. So let's go back to the beginning. Why am I creating this video? So 3.5 years ago, I found myself in a situation where I just felt like I was unfulfilled, underpaid, and just not even scratching the surface of my potential. You know, I was working a 9-to-5 job where each day it wasn't what I wanted to be doing with my life. I felt like there was so much more I had to offer. And I was hungry for success, but not just financial success. Yes, I do have that hunger and had it back then, but whole life success, just looking to be able to have in each area of my life meaning, fulfillment, and just being proud of what I was doing. And I felt like I wasn't there. And so what I started to do was consume personal development content. It started slow, and then I just went way deep down the rabbit hole of listening to podcasts, watching YouTube videos, reading books, following people online and reading their blogs of how people were transforming and changing their own lives. And what I realized is that there were regular, normal people just like myself who were creating amazing lives for themselves, and that I certainly had the capability to do so. I just had to follow some of the strategies that had been laid out in front of me. And I also recognized that there was a mechanism there for me to create the life that I had been dreaming of, and that was through entrepreneurship. And so I started to go deeper and deeper down this rabbit hole and consuming content, and realized that I wasn't alone on this search either. And that became really my mission, was to help other people who had that same desire for success, that same hunger for this holistic fulfillment in life, to achieve that. But I had one problem. Who was I to start teaching people how to achieve success in their life, to have this fulfillment, to build businesses, when I hadn't done any of that myself? I mean, like I said, I was working in a job every day, commuting to work and wondering what I was doing. It felt like a drain more so than a dream. And so what I began to do is seek out the people who actually have achieved success in their life and were living a life of abundance in these different areas. And I became a reporter. I started interviewing them because I wanted to know what they did early on in their lives and throughout their journeys to get to where they were today. And that was that first step towards entrepreneurship, like I talked about earlier. And I've now recorded over 150 of these conversations. And what I've learned is that there are patterns that these people have followed. I started seeing them from guest to guest and recognizing that there were some simple things that each of these people had done or were doing that anybody can implement in their lives. And so that's what I'm going to talk to you about in today's video and in this series of videos that we're going to be releasing, is what are those patterns and where do you start to start building this life of abundance and of freedom? And so one of the most important things that jumped out to me was that going about it alone is a whole hell of a lot harder than going about it with a group of people who either A, have done what you're looking to do, hashtag mentorship, or B, with people who are also in that journey. And so that's why I am inviting you to join in this journey with me and start building out that this beautiful life that you have this dream of. So then the question becomes, where do you even start? How do you begin to create a life that you have this vision for? And the key word there is vision. What I've realized is that if you start, let's use a road trip, for example. Let's say that you just start driving with no destination in mind. Where are you going to end up? Sure, there's the opportunity that you just randomly end up somewhere beautiful, but you can also end up in the completely wrong direction and somewhere that you don't want to be at all. That's much like living your life without a vision for it and not having an end goal in mind of where you want to be and what you want your life to look like. You have to put the coordinates in the GPS so that you're taking the chance out of it and you're working towards that destination. And your vision serves as those coordinates. It serves as that guidepost for what you're working towards. And I know that that might sound a little woo-woo or touchy-feely to you. It certainly used to me. I mean, before I started implementing these strategies that I learned and really changing my own habits and creating a vision, I had this idea that it was pointless. Why set a vision for something that's probably impossible to achieve? It just seemed like a waste of time. But I also started to realize that the most successful people that I had been talking to and interviewing and studying all had visions for their lives. And it's not that they had success and then created a vision, but rather they all had followed the same strategy of creating a vision, having an idea in their mind of where they wanted to go, and then working towards that and being strategic and taking action to create a life that reflected that vision. For example, Tony Robbins didn't become the Tony Robbins inspirational dude we all know him as today and then set a vision for his life. No. He was broke. He didn't have the skills, but he had this vision. And then he went out, he took action, and he made his current reality what it is based on that vision for his life. And so where do you start? We're going to go through four specific steps of creating your vision statement and really understanding where you want to take your life. So if you haven't already, this is our next step. We're creating it. A few things that I wanted to note before we get started. First of all, this applies to all areas of your life, not just business, or if entrepreneurship is also something you're passionate about and joining me on this journey for, but also within health and fitness, with the key relationships in your life, spirituality, whatever it may be that's important to you, this stretches the gambit of your life. Also, you have to dream big here. I don't want you to limit yourself on your own potential. Whatever first comes to mind as the realistic vision that you have set, you could set for yourself, rather than chasing that, double it. At least we're not thinking about a limited vision for our life. We're thinking about the entire possible life that we can live that is out there, not based on our current reality, but based on the reality that we're going to create for ourselves. Also, this is not meant to be set in stone. It shouldn't be set in stone. Once you think through your vision the first time, this is an evolving thing. This is something that as you grow, as you learn more and know what direction you want to take your life, you can change what this vision looks like. You can reset your vision statement. You can completely scrap it for something new if it comes to that, or you can tweak it little by little as you go along. But you're going to be reviewing it regularly, so it's something that can be adjusted. So let's go through the four steps for setting your vision statement. First, we need to list out those categories that I mentioned, the buckets of your life, the main areas of your life where that are most important to you. These are going to be different for everyone. For example, mine are relationships, spirituality, health, business, wealth, and personal life. Within those six categories, I can really fit the most important things in there in one way or another. And when I'm thinking through what I want my life to look like, those are the areas that I start to focus on because those are the most important aspects of my life. So another thing to think through before we dive into this is, well, first list those out. And now we have to think through, what do we want those areas of our life to look like in the future? And this can be different for each of us. How far in the future do you want to look depends really on your personal preference. That could be 5, 10, 15, 20, 50 years out, whatever makes sense for you. Personally, I like to use 10 years. This is a length of time that is far enough out that I know I can make huge monumental changes and really create an epic life in that amount of time, but it's not so far out that it seems totally unrealistic and I can't see myself at that point in my life. So for example, at 75 years old, that seems so far that I can't really comprehend the changes I need to make today to get to where I want to be then. So 10 years is perfect for me. Find the length of time that's really going to work for you. And again, go through these with an abundant mindset. Anything is possible. Don't use things like your current financial situation, the amount of time you have to work on your dream, things like that as a limiting factor. We'll get to that. We'll work through that in future videos and learn how we can overcome those obstacles. But go ahead and under each of those buckets, journal out what you want your life to look like and get at least a paragraph there. And for some of you, bullet points might be the way that works best for you. I know that's how I like to work through this is I'll have sentences in bullet format that of what I want my life to look like in each of those buckets and really build it out a holistic view of what you want your life to look like. And if you, I should call out, if you want to pause here and work through that as we're going through the video, then go ahead, pause it and keep working as we go. Or you can come back and rewatch this part of the video and then go through it if you want to hear the whole process first. Whatever works best for your learning style and your plan of action, go with that. So that was step one, was coming up with the buckets and this vision for your life in each of those buckets. The second step is determining your strengths. So how we're going to do this is you're going to think of maybe 5 to 7 somewhat recent in the last several years, victories that you've had, accomplishments that you've achieved, and write those down, things that you are proud of that you've experienced, things that you would consider a win in your life. And that can be in any area of your life. So jot those out. And then once you're done with that, what you're going to do is under each of those accomplishments, write down the qualities of yourself that help you accomplish that and what your strengths are that helped you to get to that win. So I'll use one for example. One of my accomplishments was passing the 3-year mark of consistently posting podcast episodes. And so when I thought through what were my strengths or qualities that helped me get to that personal victory, it was hard work, perseverance, and patience were really the 3 things that I listed under there. So you're going to do that for all of these 5 to 7 accomplishments or personal achievements, and that's going to help you identify your strengths. And you can really see, based on your historical achievements, what are your strengths? It's not just coming up with a random list of things that you think you're good at, but you can really dive into what were the things that helped you accomplish those things. So now you have a list of strengths. Let's go on to the third step of the process, which is determining your core values. And this one is a little bit more subjective, and you can think about what you want your core values in your life to be, the things that really define who you are as a person or what it currently is right now. And list out just either single words or phrases, what core values you want to encompass in your life. And if you need a little bit of help with this, I know that I did. We created a cheat sheet with a large list of values that you can select from. So you can check that out. That's at millennialmm.com/values. We'll have that linked up below. Go there, pick out any values, write as many down as you can think of that are important to you. And then once you have that list, it might be 10, 15 long, maybe shorter or longer. go through and circle, highlight, star, whatever it is, the ones that are the most important to you, the top 1 to 2 that you really want to encompass in your life. So now you're going to have your strengths, your values that you want to incorporate, and a general picture in the major buckets of your life, what you want your life to look like in 10 years. So we're going to take those three aspects and boil this down in the fourth step of creating your vision statement. So take those key strengths, maybe your top 1 or 2 strengths that you came out through step 2, and your core values that you've identified, and make sure that you're incorporating this into a statement of 1 to 3 sentences. You know, this isn't a competition for length here. Actually, the more concise, the better. But you want to, in a couple of sentences, you want to explain what you want your life to look like. You want to write a statement that really summarizes where you want your life to go, how you want to live your life. So I'm going to link mine up below so you guys can see an example of how I created this. This is subjective of how you word this. That's not a template. This is just an example. But go ahead and check that out if you want an example, and come up with your vision statement. And now you really have a short, concise way that you can visit daily or weekly, whatever works best for you, of where you want your life to go and how you want to live your life. So a few notes here. It doesn't have to be perfect. It won't be perfect the first time. Again, like I said earlier, this can be an iterative process that you change this over time, you tweak it, you make it more relevant to what's going on in your life as time goes on. And you're going to change. You're going to grow as a person. So your vision will change and grow. So now you have a vision statement. What's next? Where do you go from here? Well, I know that you might be thinking, okay, great. I have this vision for my life, but that doesn't change anything about my life today. Well, even if you don't take any more action, which we're going to get to, you will be taking more action as we walk through these videos if you hang on and come along with me for this journey. But even if you don't, subconsciously, you've already identified where you want your life to go. And so you will be working towards this vision without even necessarily realizing it, because at least now you have defined what that looks like. You have the coordinates in the GPS, and that's amazing. I highly encourage revisiting this over time and on a regular basis. Like I said, that might be daily, every morning you read this. That might be once a week where you have it on your calendar and it pops up. But definitely make sure that you're revisiting this statement and that you're revisiting this vision that you have for your life. And I know that some of you will think, okay, all right, I have this vision. I want to share one quick anecdotal story of my good friend, let's call him Mark for the sake of this story, who went through this process. He wrote out a vision and he even set some specific goals for his future self, which that's a little teaser. We're going to be getting into the goals in a future video. But he's the type of guy that if you don't have empirical evidence that something works, science doesn't necessarily back it up, he's not really buying into it. So he did this, went through this process, and tucked it away in a notebook and didn't think anything of it. It was more of he went through it as part of a course or something that he had been taking and never put any thought behind it. Well, several years later, he comes across that notebook, pulls it out, and is reading through his vision for his life and the goals he had set, and realized, look how I'm 95% of the way there. I've accomplished many of these goals that I thought were nearly impossible when I set them. And this vision that I had for my life looks a whole lot more like it does, like I thought it was possible to then. Today, I'm starting to live that vision. And so it was just a cool story when he shared this with me of, even if you're not necessarily following this vision and revisiting it on a daily or weekly basis, you've already planted the seed and you'll work towards that. And so for those of my skeptical friends out there, just let's go on this journey. Let's give this a shot and let's see where it can take you. There's absolutely no downside and a hell of a lot of upside. I'm also not saying that just by creating this vision that Say entrepreneurship, for example, is also your goal, and that's where we're going to be focusing a lot with these videos, and that's my focus, and so it comes through here in the Millennial Mastermind. But say that you have this vision and that's incorporated. You're not just going to have a business tomorrow because you've come up with a vision statement. No, there's action required there. Now, though, again, you have the coordinates in there for where to head, and you can start to make changes in your life and start creating this business and coming up with the ideas that are going to contribute and work towards that vision. Again, rather than just hoping for the best, you know which direction that you want to go. And I'm also, like I said, not all about just letting our subconscious mind take over and doing this for us. We're going to set some goals. We're going to be very action oriented on how to intentionally get to the place that we want to go. So where that leads into where we're going to take this video series moving forward. You're going to see another video come out in the next few days that's more about that goal setting piece. That is the second step. Once you have your vision set, that's where we're going to go from there. So make sure before that you work on this vision so that you can build on it and go through this process as a community, as a group, and we can work on this thing together. So keep an eye out for that next video. In the meantime, I just have one ask of you. Leave a comment below. I want to hear what are those buckets in your life? Where is what's the first bucket that you are going to be working on? And if you have any questions, comments, anything that you want to share, drop that below. Let's do this thing and go through it together.